Alright, we're back on Dr. Mario and Puzzle League. Tonight I'm gonna beat level 21 and then move on to the challenge mode, I guess, this one. Alright, let's go up here. Play on low. Ooh, chill is like actually a good one. Alright, we're just beating this level. That's all we need to do. I'm ready to be frustrated, let's go. I don't understand why there's only 21 levels. So the strat we learned yesterday is that we don't take chances. Oh god. This is already bad. I actually don't like the low speed. I think I've adjusted to medium enough that I could probably play a medium with no problem. They don't lock in place as fast. What's this? Yeah, I already regret picking low speed for this one. Oh, that was a dumb decision right there. It's fine though. This is freaking great. I will say the low speed definitely makes it significantly easier. I'm actually gonna do this. So I need to work my way up to that yellow there that's kind of trapped. Oh. Okay. Works, I guess. God, it makes it so much easier to have it on low speed. But again, I think I actually adjusted to medium, to be honest. Okay, we can start building up now, I think. Now there's no viruses to stack on, so that's kind of nice, actually. I should just stack a bunch of reds now in there. Interesting having to clear things from the bottom. If you want to put something here. I don't want to leave that for too long, actually. This is probably the best decision. Let's clear out top of this virus, which I don't know how I let that happen, to be honest. Okay. It's nice because we have ways to clear it, at least. Yellow, that'd be great. There we go. A bit of a precarious situation, actually. I need like a couple double yellows in a row, I think. No! Heck, that's not what I wanted. This is fine. Let's clear this before it's too late. Wait, what am I doing? I need to clear these yellows. I get blue, red. No, I did a mistake. No! Okay, that's a good piece too, actually. Keep an eye out for those. Okay, fine. put that. I don't like it. I would like that. Thank you. More of that. Okay. I just need blue now. Thank you. Blue? Thank you. Okay. Okay, that was much, much easier than low speed, I think. Oh, there's more. Okay, you know what? I think this might be endless, actually. Okay. It keeps going, yeah. We'll say that 21's the cap. Actually, I think 20 was the cap, to be honest. Alright, we're moving on to Flash, which is... clearing viruses. I'm gonna play on medium, actually. Give the CPU hard. And give the CPU easy. Dude, I could literally rig this in my favor. Yeah, we'll put the CPU on normal. We'll do everything normal, I guess. We gotta go with our banger sneeze. Is this even like a mode that has an objective? Doesn't seem like it, actually. Oh, hello. That's nice. Heck. What? Yeah, this just seems to be a CPU battle. It's kind of lame. I thought this was going to be like a puzzle mode. Oh my goodness. Dude, I'm literally blocking myself. I don't feel like this is a game that I need to beat, actually, now that I am seeing what it is. Oh, heck. Thank you. I'm screwed. Yeah. No. Okay, maybe normal CPU is a little too difficult. Okay, yeah, I thought this was like a puzzle mode or something. Okay, so there's like the classic mode and the flash mode, and then there's the vertical one, but we can't really do that with this. So I guess we're done with Dr. Mario then. I don't like really know. There's no like puzzle mode. So, like, there's nothing really to beat. You just play classic, I guess, until you reach level 21. I don't know. I did it. I reached level 20 last night. I beat it. Like, I don't see how this is necessary, because it's not like there's a specific, like, set of levels you have to do. Okay, I'm gonna call Dr. Mario done, actually. Looks like you can play with a person that doesn't even have a link cable. Or doesn't even have the game. Alright. Let's play some Puzzle League. Then. This is actually what I've been looking forward to for this game, is I really like Puzzle League a lot. Yeah, this is what... This I'm probably going to have to beat. Pokemon 10 for 20 bucks. Like the Pokemon card ones. Alright, let's do a marathon. That's slow. Right in the middle, I guess. Oh, nice. Do you like resell the cards or something? Alright, Puzzle League is super fun. I love Puzzle League a lot. Very different from Dr. Mario. This is very slow, though. Feels different from another Puzzle League game that I played recently, so... might throw me off a little bit. How you speed it up. That's some nice music too. See, I still have all my Pokemon cards from my childhood, but I don't think I'd ever be able to sell them. Just because they're collectibles, I don't know. I wouldn't want to sell them, personally. Saving them. Good call. Yeah. I wonder how it would, how do you do that? I wonder how much... I wonder how I could appraise, like, my own GBA games. But like, once I'm done with them, like, I don't know. I kind of want to keep some of them, but not all of them, because there's, like, really bad games that I don't ever want to see again, so... I wonder how you would go about, like, solving that for GBA games, like, what the value is. Oh, I see. There's gotta be one of those tools for, like, everything, probably. Spreadsheets are like always the way to go. I love making spreadsheets for random reasons. Even if like I probably don't need a spreadsheet for something, I still make a spreadsheet for it because it's just fun. No, I will unashamedly say I've sat and played Puzzle League for hours before, because it's just so much fun. Nice. That's pretty epic. I could probably play at a faster speed, to be honest. I've played Puzzle League enough that I'd like to think I'm fairly skilled. Not amazing, but fairly skilled, at least. I just went with slow because I'm not used to this version of Puzzle League yet. Quintuple, let's go. Those are rare. This just gives me so much nostalgia from my childhood. I just love playing this game as a kid. I could literally play this for so long and not get tired of it. Wait. Dang, I wasn't in time for that. Should have waited on that. Sonic on GBA? Dude, I remember the Sonic games on GBA being pretty good. Dude, I have to play a lot of garbage on this console. Like, I'm playing every single game. Every single game on the Game Boy Advance that was released in North America. There's worse games than Sonic Advance. Plus, Sonic Advance is the Tiny Chao Garden. That already gives it, like, a huge plus in my eyes. Even though the tiny Chao Garden isn't, like, fantastic, it's still a Chao Garden, and Chao Gardens are perfect. They're the best game design. Yeah. I'd like to play Four Swords as well, but I don't know if I can figure it out with either my flash cart and the cartridge I actually have, or, like, the emulator. Dude, every single game, like, if you see it, if you know a GBA game, I'm playing it in this challenge. Or maybe I've already played it. I don't know. I've already beaten 7 games, so... Okay, at some point I might actually have to quit out of this. Because I don't think I'm gonna be dying on this speed level. Dude, I don't care if it drops inputs. I gotta play it, and if it drops inputs, then it drops inputs. And I will lower the rating for it. Not that the rating means anything coming from me. I'm not, like, a professional, like, game critic or anything. I just thought it'd be a fun thing to do. Since I'm playing every game, I might as well get my thoughts on it. So there's some connection. Some human connection to the challenge. That's actually the lowest rating so far. If you were in charge of the ratings and we kept my ratings, that'd be the lowest rating so far. Because I gave the Bible game like a 3 out of 10, because that game is pretty garbage. Even though I am of a culture who would probably like that game, it was not a good game. Well, I mean, it's Mortal Kombat on a Game Boy Advance. Like, what do you want from it? There's only so much you can do on this system. Like, the system is archaic. Archaic for today. It was actually pretty advanced for its time. Mortal Kombat 2. Dude, I've actually never played a Mortal Kombat game, so I don't even know what, like, the different Mortal Kombat things are. I'm not super into, like, blood and gore related games, so it's gonna be really interesting when we hit some of those. I probably won't. Dude, it's not gonna change my opinion of the series. I'm probably never gonna play another Mortal Kombat game ever again, so. It's not going to change my opinion of the franchise. Because I don't even have an opinion on the franchise. And I doubt that that's going to give me one, so... We're just clearing everything right now. Dang, not in time. Hey, so the Shrek game I've already played, this which was the second game of the challenge, which someone memed, was actually pretty good. I'm not even gonna lie, the Shrek game that I played so far was actually not even a bad game at all. It's actually a pretty solid game. So I have a little bit better expectations for the Shrek games now. Yo, Benny, picking the GBA game that goes next. What's it gonna be? Remember, it has to be one that I have. Disney Princess? Oh, Pog, let's go. Man, you guys love picking, like, the garbage games. You guys just love it. And I love it. I appreciate you guys picking all the garbage games early. Wait. Oh, shoot. Not what I wanted to do. Full screen this so I can actually see what I'm doing. Where's the... I'll add it to the document. Yeah, I don't have that one yet. I will eventually, though. I will play every single game on GBA. It's gonna happen. Let me just add that to the docket here. Disney Princess. Where is that one on here? There it is. It's picked. Alright. Oh, shoot. Thank you for another pick. Alright, I'll put those both on the queue so I don't forget. Disney Princess. That's. Yeah, we're getting all the bad ones out of the way early, so. Alright, I'm appreciate you picking some games, but Benny. Appreciate that a lot. Hold on, actually, I should probably mark that one as picked on here as well. Oh, we've had some pretty awful games so far, so... But maybe they won't be bad. I don't know. What is that, Benny? Double there by Benny, the great YouTube. I'm gonna move this up a little bit, it's gonna bug me otherwise. Maybe I'll have my cousin help me play Disney Princess. I guess my cousin is likes to make fun of me for the games I play, so she's like really into that kind of Disney Princess stuff, you know? Nicktoons Racing is a perfect game. What video is this? Hold on. Do I have Nicktoons Racing? I don't think I do. I have a couple Nicktoons games. Wow. Don't plan on it. I'll play the game myself when I get it. Don't you worry. It's interesting. So far, like, people have only picked games that I think anybody would think would be bad. Like, every single game pick so far is a game that the person who chose it thought it'd be a bad game. And so far, I've actually been surprised by a few of them, but most of them have actually been terrible. But it's okay. We're okay with terrible games as long as we get them done. You're on a stream called The Bread Ghost. Okay. I think I get the idea with marathon mode, so I'm just gonna quit out because I don't think I need to really beat anything here. I think what I really need to beat here is do this and this, probably. Timed. What is this? No. Yeah, this is what we're looking for in terms of completion. Completing all these levels, basically. Yes, Benny. If you look on the GameCube page and you scroll down, you'll see that I put pretty much all first party games at like 50 to 25 game intervals. 25 to 50 game intervals. All the Pokemon games are spaced out at like 100, 300, 500. So we have games to look forward to for sure. And the last game is a game that I really love and enjoy. The very last game of the challenge. So I'm basically, I see the whole challenge as a road to play Pokemon Mystery Dungeon again. That's how I see it. That's how I'm getting through all the bad stuff. Yeah, Red Rescue Team is the reward, as I consider that game to be the best game on the Game Boy Advance. That's the game that I think is probably the best game on the system. Yeah, Mario Golf's kind of far down. I mean, maybe I'll make a Channel Punch reward to swap, like, the good games to earlier in the queue. Like, move a good game wherever you want it. Or not wherever you want it. Like, switch it with another game. Another good game that's already preset. Oh, that could be interesting, I guess. I kind of put them in random places, so Mario Golf just got the short end of the stick by being towards the back. One sec. No, Benny. This is probably going to take me longer than I'm ever going to stream, so I don't even know if I'm going to finish it, but my mom's asking for a YouTube link. I don't plan on doing any other challenges beyond this one. This one's literally probably gonna take me like 10 years to finish, if I even finish it, so. Which I hope, I really, really want to. I really want to finish it. But is that like all the Wii games, like just period, or is that all the Wii games released in North America? Because this challenge is only the games released in North America, which is 950. If I did all the GBA games released ever, it'd be over 1,000. It'd easily be 1,500. And that would take probably the rest of my life to complete, so. Or at least another 10 years. Because then I have to, like, actually get the games from Japan and Europe. It's more money than I'm willing to sink into this, and I'm already sinking way too much. That's North America. Dang. Well, that makes sense, though, if the Wii had such a long console life. Like, the Wii was still... The Wii still had games being made for it, like, a couple years ago, even, I think. Makes perfect sense. For the Virtual Boy. There are consoles that have very few games on them, so... You could probably do it for... console with, like, very few games. But, well, that really feels satisfying. To have beaten every game on the Virtual Boy. Yeah, Just Dance 2020. Dude, like, literally this year. It's cool why that's the last game on the Wii, though. Why they kept making Just Dance. It's a cool reason. I hope if you die here, you don't have to go all the way back to the beginning. You have two Virtual Boy games? I don't even know when the Virtual Boy even was a thing. I'm sure it's probably hard to get your hands on a Virtual Boy game. Wait, where was the line there? We're on 2-1 now. First Mario Tennis. Is that one on Virtual Boy? Isn't that the console where it's like prototype VR, and you like put your face into it? And it was like a commercial failure. Oh my gosh. It's ridiculous. Because I can't believe you even have one of those. I don't even know when it came out. Oh, I see. The first 3D Mario game? There's one of those on the Virtual Boy too? This is more of the speed I'm used to, I feel like, with Puzzle League. '95, okay, 2 years before I was born, then. Wait, what? I'm confused. Wait, there's no line on that level. How many stages of this there are? I like this music too. It's just so chill. This game is so chill to play. Oh, now we got an interesting layout here. Wow, I got that in time. Yeah, I think for Dr. Mario, I played it. I think it was Gilgatex. His rule for like puzzle games is that if you can beat the marathon mode, do that. There's a way to win. If not, just play it through. And there was no like puzzle mode for Dr. Mario. There was just a CPU battle, basically. I might go back and check one more time before I leave the game, but. Yeah, I feel like Puzzle League is like the main attraction of this game. Dr. Mario is nice and all. Dr. Mario is always fun. I could literally probably play that for hours. Given enough time. But this is like the main attraction of this game because it actually has like a mission mode, basically. I mean, this isn't even the mission mode. This is just like extra like clear to the line. Wow, I literally did a midair there. That's pretty sick. I wonder, it seems the last stage is just kind of like a boss fight where you're just breaking as many as you need to. There's no line, particularly. The blue is added in now. Faster too. I think I can play at a pretty decent speed though. It's harder to get combos though at this speed. getting pretty fast. Stages there are of this. Shit, I didn't think they're quick enough. Okay, that one was tough. That one's starting even higher now. I keep turning the wrong pieces. Or attacking Sakurai. My god. Yes, just attack someone who has literally nothing to do with the issue. Sure, that's gonna solve a lot of problems now. I hate people. I hate people so much. Shows that the Smash community is full of whiny babies who really can't take it when someone insults their game or stands against them. You know, the Smash community is why I didn't want to speedrun initially, why I didn't like speedrunning initially. I thought speedrunners were the same as Smash players, they were elitists who couldn't... Shoot. What do I even do here? I can't talk and play this game. I screwed that up. Okay. Okay, thank goodness. A little bit of a break there. Dude, what do I even do? I have, like, nothing. Come on. Give me something. Oh. Okay, there's something. No! Please tell me I can just start from there again. Okay, thank God. This is an example of a game that is good because it has checkpoints. Unlike a couple games that I've already played in this challenge, where they literally had no checkpoints whatsoever. Alright, Benny, you have a good night, man. Thanks for the good luck. Yo, RDA! I ordered Snood, by the way, RDA. I felt bad that you redeemed it and asked for Snood and I didn't have it, so I ordered it. I found a good deal. So it should be on the way. Taking a while to get here, though. So I'll add that to the list. For the future, though, like, for, like, special requests like that, I'm gonna require, like, donations or subs, because I can't just go off spending my money all the time. So. I hope it ends up being a good game to play, yeah. You seem to be giving it some high praise, so. Okay, there we go. I'm so glad this game has checkpoints. Yeah. Getting kind of fast for me. Oh, what is this? What's this? Okay, that was really scary. Whew. Give myself a little bit of a mental break there. Alright, RDA, what do we got? Ooh! Ooh! That's one I have not played in a very long time, so I'm really happy you picked that one. Yeah, we will do that then. That'll be also be on the flash cart, because I don't have that game currently, but I have played it before, so I feel okay. I mean, I don't know. I don't, like, the Spyro Orange is not a very good game, from what I remember, which is, that's the counterpart to it. I didn't watch the speedrun in Spyrothon for Spyro Orange, but I don't remember that game being particularly great, so... I haven't played Crash Bandicoot Purple in a really long time, so I don't remember, personally. I don't think I ever beat it, personally. I like how everyone's just trying to pick all these terrible games for me to play. You're all looking out for me, so I don't have terrible games later. Yeah, it's interesting, I have a physical cartridge for Spyro Orange, but I don't have one for Crash Purple. Frick. I need to see. Wow, that was really hard. Yeah, I think they're pretty similar games. It's just that they have different mechanics based on which particular franchise it's based on. I don't remember, though. I might have actually played someone else's copy of Crash Purple, but I do remember playing it. I love this game so much. It actually has checkpoints like it should. Like all games should. You don't have to literally restart every time you die. Oh my gosh. Dude, this is hard. How many stages are there? We got 3 game picks tonight. That's like a new record for a stream. Thank you. No! I was mashing A and it didn't work. Dude, speed is so high. You really gotta start comboing at this level. It's really hard to combo at this level. Dude, it gives you so much stoppage time this far down. Frick. I don't have anything. And I guess I did have something. I couldn't see anything there. Not in time anyway. Really hard. This has to be the last stage, right? There's no way it could go much faster than this. Yeah, if you're this close to the top, it gives you way more stoppage time. Oh, thank goodness. Oh my god, there's more. Dude, it's giving me nothing. Oh my god, I couldn't even combo there. That was lame. I don't have enough. Okay. Dude, this is so scary. I played that so wrong. There were so many better things I could have done there. Why is it so hard to find combos? Dude, it's so hard to find combos! Oh, I could've comboed there, I wasn't fast enough. Dude, oh my god, it's so hard to play this with a GameCube D-pad. Dude, what do I even do? It's going too fast. I can't keep up. Seeing the combos in time. Okay, thank you. Because of the kind of thing that would be 10 stages long. Dude, what do I even do in this situation? Oh my gosh, it goes so fast. Dude, you have no time to think. Like, you just gotta find your combo in, like, the first 2 seconds, I guess. Or do that. Get yourself a lot of time to work with. Oh my god, it goes so fast! Dude! Dude, I could not move the cursor where I wanted it to go. There's no dexterity with this cursor. So fast. Dude, that was the wrong way. Why? I was actually close on that one. There was no way on that one. Oh my god, I didn't even see the right side. This is just mean. This is just mean, dude. This is like, you literally have to like get a combo right at the beginning. That's what it feels like. Wasn't that a five? Why did I not get any time stop? It's like fives aren't good enough anymore. Dude, you literally won't let me win. Dude, come on. I can't move fast enough. I literally don't even think I can move fast enough. Okay, that could be something. Actually, no, it can't because it didn't stop enough. More of that valuable stoppage time, dude. Wow. How do you even do this? It's going so fast. Dude, it went to the wrong piece again. This is actually, like, ridiculously difficult. That was bad. I can't see the combos fast enough, and that's the issue. You really need to know how to combo in this if you want to win. Oh I can't see them quickly enough. I didn't even know where to go there. Like, there's plenty of places I could, like, just clear pieces, but I really need the combos. And I just don't have enough time to see them. See, it's just, it's so fast that I have no time to keep up. Die so quickly because it moves so fast. See, it's just, it goes so fast that you can't keep up with it. It's not possible to keep up with it. My god, why? I'm not even getting close. The thing. Dude. You really, okay, that's another strat. You let it get to the top and then you do a clear that stops it, but then you're all the way at the top. And that's a problem. Please just stop. Please just stop. Please, something work. Oh my gosh. I don't know how I'm gonna get past this. Frick. See, I can't get to the combos fast enough. Dude, I hit the wrong piece again. I wanted to go to the right and I hit to the left. This is so hard. And I don't have a combo, of course. And of course I moved the wrong piece. It's taking so long. I need to stop waiting and I need to actually go for combos. No, I had nothing. This is really difficult. Why wasn't that a combo? I hit the wrong piece again. Wasting time. I'm playing as fast as I can right now. It's not fast enough. Frick. Okay, we did it. Holy frick, that was hard. I don't know what I'm gonna do if there's 10 stages of this. Oh my god. Gosh. Is this even possible? I just... Okay, this is gonna be very hard. That's the strat. We wanna get the... I wanna get that really early. That big stop. Dude, this is moving so fast. I'm panicking. Wasn't fast enough for that combo. You can't go fast enough to get these combos. Why? It's literally Puzzle League Impossible mode here. How does anyone play at this speed? I got nothing. Alright, nothing again. Oh my gosh. This is very hard. I don't have anything. Nothing. I can see the line now, at least. Why? I hope there isn't much more after this, because I don't know how I'm gonna solve anything faster than this. How did that not count as a combo? What the frick? Got robbed. Should have been actually playing there instead of adjusting my glasses. That time stopped. No. Just get over there. Oh my gosh. Okay, that was actually a really good place. I'm really happy that I played there. Now I'm not gonna do this. Oh my gosh, what is this? Focus on the combos, I guess. Wherever I can. I don't know if combos are like the only things that do anything to the meter. Okay. Dude, I tried to switch it and it didn't work. I got nothing. I couldn't see anything. I still don't see anything. Oh my gosh. Yeah, it's you have to get combos to lower that meter. Again, you had to get lucky with the pieces too, which is very unfortunate. There's a huge luck element involved. Like, if you don't get a good combo at the beginning, you're screwed. lost here. I didn't get a good combo, so I got screwed. Please tell me this is the last level. There's no more after this. There's nothing I could do about that. I have nothing. I can't see anything in time, dude. I'm freaking blind. I can't even set anything up. Literally nothing again. I should go for a 5 every single time. The fives are perfectly timed to get the max stoppage. Oh, I almost had that one too. I turned the wrong piece again. I have nothing. Oh my gosh. This is impossible. Well, a little bit of luck, it's not. I can't imagine it being much more difficult than this. So I feel like this is probably the last level in this particular mode. These game developers seem to be pretty sadistic, so. Who knows? I have nothing there. I need to get a good 5. That's what I need. Here's my 5. Perfect. See, like, the 5 is perfectly timed to get you the max stoppage. I don't know why, it just is. But now I have nothing, so it doesn't really matter. I could have actually gotten a combo there. No. I didn't see that one in time. Thank you. I need to play to the bottom, I think, more often. Oh my gosh. Trapped there. If I can keep comboing, like, down here, I can keep refreshing the thing, maybe. Maybe not. Nothing again. Combos. Perfectly timed. Think I got it? Yes! Okay, that's the strat. The strat is to, like, get it to squish and then perfectly time it. Oh, thank goodness. Okay, yeah, I knew it couldn't have gotten much harder after that. Oh my goodness. Okay, we still have the other puzzles to do, which are a lot less stressful. It's more puzzle than anything else. Oh, that was so stressful. But I do think that's a little easier in Dr. Mario. It's a lot less... Well, I think actually there's a lot more going on. Oh, hey, Bill Tran's in this credits roll. It's an interesting one. We're not ending with the credits. Maybe we will end with the credits. Because I still have to do the other mode. It might have the credits as well. I feel accomplished having beaten that. See, that's good game design. That right there is, it gives you a checkpoint. It doesn't send you all the way back to the beginning if you fail. It's like, okay, try it again. Try it again. Get better at the game. Get better at the game. That's what a game is supposed to do. It's supposed to make you get better at it. Whereas with, like, the freaking Lego game, it was like, oh, you died once to this one enemy, let's send you all the way back to the beginning of the level, do it all again. It's so tedious. But with this, it's like, you're actually learning. Oh, Iwata. We have to obligatory cry. We all miss Iwata. Alright. Oh, this is made by intelligent systems, no wonder it's so good. Okay. Oh boy. Vertical mode. Oh yeah, we don't want to do vertical mode though. I don't think I'd ever beaten that mode before, line mode. How many stages of this are there? Only 6 stages and then 10 each. Seems about right. Yeah, that's pretty easy. So this is a lot less stressful as they're just solving the puzzle basically every time. So we can chill with these, I think. I think once we're done with these, we can be done with this game. Oh, and there's hints, too. Oh, but I don't think I can get the hints, because... Oh, wait, the select button is probably Y and X. We'll use the hints if we get stuck. For right now, it's probably not going to be too useful to have hints. I love this game. This is such a good game. I'd give this one probably something in the 8 range. Maybe even 9, honestly. Like, this is a really solid game. I mean, you have Dr. Mario. That's what it is. But, like... Puzzle League is just, like, a whole thing on its own. It's just a great game. And it's, again, I could play this game for hours and not get tired of it. I've played Puzzle League for hours before without getting tired of it. And like other Puzzle League games too, like Pokemon Puzzle Challenge. I played that a ton. I haven't done these before, by the way. I just see the solution right away. These ones are pretty easy. They get harder later. When you have to do more than one move. I think there's a rendition of this in Pokemon Puzzle Challenge as well. I have that on the 3DS. Three turns here. Okay. Yeah, I want to do this. It's fives. There we go. One turn for this. They'll get harder, I believe. Actually, to think a little bit about that one. Once again, I'll check Dr. Mario one more time once I'm done with these. This is so much more chill. I just don't think there's anything left for me to do in Dr. Mario. There wasn't like a puzzle mode like this. Three turns here. That'll work. Holy frick. Well, that one's pretty obvious, but like it looked daunting at first. 30 blocks cleared with that. That's awesome. I may have seen some of these before. Not entirely sure. That seemed pretty obvious to me. Two turns. Oh, that wasn't it. Oh, probably that. Oh, there we go. That one was clever. I want to do this probably. Oh, wait. How am I gonna clear? Oh, I see. I wasn't sure about that. I guess I got it. You know what was really nice about, what was really nice about that, line mode is that it did feel very difficult in the last stages, but it wasn't too difficult. And that's important, I think. About this. I think I have to pull these ones out from under. Yeah. Pull one of them out from under. I don't know if it would have mattered. Would it have mattered which one I pulled? No, it didn't really matter. I got done either way. Sometimes you can see the whole puzzle all at once and figure out how it's solved. I think other times you just have to look at each individual piece, like what happens if this piece moves. I think my brother would really like this. My brother's really good at puzzles. Okay, the purples are gonna be in a 5, probably. I did not mean to do that. I think I accidentally bumped the select button. That costs you time. That's kind of silly. Well, I guess that's what the hint does. I didn't mean to hit that, but okay. Well, now it seems pretty obvious. Let's do that. Did not mean to do that. Not at all. Oh, this again. Well, you're just moving this again, right? That was really easy. What's that doing in the middle of stage 3? These two have to get out of the way. I have to somehow... Oh, wow. How do I do this? Oh, okay. So I think I see. I need to move one of these hearts so it lands over here. Probably this one. And then... do that. That doesn't work. Because I don't want when the hearts fall, I don't want them to how do I do this? I need to actually do stuff. Okay, so there's enough purples that I could probably clear one set of purples right away. Or at least do like that, maybe. Oh, that doesn't really work, because I still need to get the hearts. The red ones, in such a way that I can actually clear them. Okay. I can't clear any reds until I can actually get them all in one line. I only have two turns to do this, though. That's why I'm so confused. I did that. I don't think that helped me much. What if I did this? No, that doesn't help me either. I can't clear the reds. So I can't move either of these two blocks on the first move. Because that'll clear too many reds. So the only blocks I can really move are like and then how do I get the reds to work? Yeah, the one on top is the one that's confusing me, because I'm like, I mean, the reds were confusing me, so I was like, how do you clear these? This clearly has to be a five stack. Three moves for this one. That one was way easier than the last one. Two moves. So these ones, the light blue ones, are going to be cleared probably by a four stack somehow. I could literally spam hints just to get through it, but I'm not going to do that because that's lame and cheap. Okay, I think this. Yeah, that's the right play. That was a good play. Purples obviously have to fall. Like, you could just do this and that, but then, like, you leave the greens. Good song. Like, this seems like the obvious solution, but it's not the solution because the greens get left hanging. I definitely think the purple needs to be in a stack somehow. It's interesting how that turns out. Oh! I was so convinced the purple would be in a stack, I didn't even see it. These are so satisfying to solve. Thank you, Randomizer, for picking this game. Two turns. That worked really nicely. Turns on this one as well. Okay, that one's pretty easy. Saw that right away. I think that's definitely one of the moves. Maybe not, actually. Oh, that's not gonna work with any of the stars to be aligned. Something about this game that just makes me happy. I like playing this game. I'm gonna be sad when it's over. We must move on to the bad stuff after this. How do I get the yellows in a four? I think the yellows are the key to this. I'm just not sure how to get them in a position where I can actually... Oh wait, maybe... No, that won't work. I did that, and then did like this. Doesn't really work now, does it? The yellows obviously have to be in a horizontal four line, because these two are already on the bottom. You can't have a vertical line for yellows. So at some point I need to move this one over. That's all I know so far. Maybe I don't have to move that one over, actually. I thought I just had an idea. I'm just staring at this, like marveling, like how could this possibly work? Because like you always seem to be sacrificing one color to get the other ones right. Can't clear the yellows until this one is down. This one's so obvious, but I just can't see it. Oh, there it is. How did I not realize that? So I just needed to push this one all the way over here. I see, I knew there had to be a gap. I had to put a gap in between the yellows somehow. It was just like that. That was pretty obvious, actually. I was overthinking it too much. Two for this? Three again. Okay, what do we got? I got five light blue, four of the other ones. One turn for this one. Okay, there's one piece I have to move to make this work. It's probably towards the bottom, actually. Looks like that, potentially. Nope, not that one. It's like pulling the last pin out of a Jenga tower before it falls over. Okay, so I have to like do one that's going to cause a chain reaction. Or pulling the pin on a grenade or something. Hold on. There's so many pieces that could possibly do it. I feel. No, that didn't do anything. I feel like this is literally just trial and error. Like, figure it out. Which one is it? Let's see. I'm glad there is this mode in this game. I don't know if I've said it already, but like, it's much more relaxing to have this kind of mode where you're just thinking. It's not like a whole bunch of like, I need to move my cursor around super quickly to make sure I get all the combos, all the wombo combos. I'm being cringe now. Always cringe. Nope, that wasn't that one. Usually it's one towards the bottom for these ones, because that's what causes the biggest chain reaction, is one at the bottom. I already tried that one. I already tried that one too, I think. I don't think it's any of the edge pieces. I think I actually have to clear something in the middle somewhere. What is the question? wouldn't be that one, would it? It's not that. No. Couldn't be. Already tried that one. This is a toughie. Kind of clear in the middle, though. There's like nothing. Besides, like this, and like. I don't even know what else. There's no hearts I can clear. Well, that could do it. Maybe. Never mind. Already tried that. Already tried this? Maybe I haven't. How are the purples gonna clear though? Yeah, so that one doesn't work, that one doesn't work. We've already confirmed those ones. This one doesn't do anything. This one definitely doesn't do anything. Nothing to be cleared up here. I don't want to use a hint on this one because it's a one turn, so any of these turns could do it. Or like, not any of them, but like... I need to... something has to clear. Something has to clear here. I think I've already tried all the edge pieces. Tried that, pretty sure. Oh, wait. How did I not try that before? Okay, that worked. What? I thought I had tried that one. Because it was an edge piece. I just hadn't tried all of them yet for some reason. That one wasn't terrible. Two turns again. Oh, okay, I need to get the yellows. What? I didn't realize I only had one turn left. Do, do, do. What if it's as simple as just moving the yellow piece over like that? Obviously not, but... banger of a song. This is like perfect puzzle solving music, to be honest. It's so happy, and it's like just, it's like good thinking music. God, I love this game. I'm going to give this game like a 9 out of 10. This game is like pretty solid. And you have Dr. Mario too. Dr. Mario's always super fun. And Puzzle League in general is just really awesome. I love Puzzle League. How do I do this? I'll probably give it like an 8.5 though. I don't know. I feel like the difficulty kind of spiked in both games pretty quickly after a little bit. Good ideas. They're all in threes, so like... Oh, frick. I didn't mean to do that. Well, now I know where the first move is, I guess. Okay, now it's pretty obvious. Once you have the first move, it's just like really obvious. I keep like moving my controller in such a way that I accidentally hit the hint button. I feel like it's also wanting you to always combo when it comes to the solution. Doesn't really change it when if I take one of these out, and I think I don't want to do that, but I do have a feeling that it has something to do with pulling this out, pulling one of these two. I'm under the impression that these need to fall straight down. So those are probably staying where they are. So probably only moving something in, up in the above. No way they want you to clear something first. So lost. That work? No, that won't work. So confused. Oh, wait, hold on. No, it won't work either. What do I even do? One do this? How does this work? There we go. I wasn't sure about that one, but then I was like, okay, this'll work if I pull that one. I gotta really look for those, like, stacks of threes. Like, three rows. For those ones. Okay, we have seven yellows. Okay, I think... I won't want to touch green at all for this one. No. That does not seem right. Oh, wow. Wow, that actually worked. I guessed on that one. I wasn't actually sure about that answer. It felt right. Two moves. Okay, we don't want to move that purple, that's for sure. And before that's the only piece you move. There you go. First one's always the easiest for each stage, it looks like. To stack them in threes. can't clear anything. I need to be able to clear something, so... I think... Let's see... I think green is the one I need to clear. Yeah, just like that. Stars are at the bottom. That's a little odd. So that means I probably need to actually... Hold on. That means purple probably needs to cause the reaction. That seems logical to me. Star. So purple probably doesn't cause it then. It looks like it does, but if it doesn't, then what does cause the reaction? This purple needs to get cleared somehow. Well, maybe. Something to do with this. I probably need to get purple in a straight line somehow. Yeah, probably. So I need to get purple in a straight line, I need to get yellow. I need to swap these two yellows. But then, what clears? I need to swap those two yellows somehow, but how do I do that? Yellow can't be the clear color because there's too much crap in between it and the bottom, so it has to be purple. There's no way you can get blue in a position to do that. Only purple can get in a position to do that, but then how do I do that without ruining the yellow? This. already tried that. Yellow doesn't work as a clear color for this. Or maybe I can move one of these. That's probably it, to be honest. To finish this tonight, but I don't think I'm going to be able to. It's getting late. And there's still so many stages left. And they're all going to get more confusing than this one. That I don't think I can finish tonight. I could use hints, I guess, but I don't want to. I feel like these are easy enough that I could probably figure them out on my own power, my own willpower. Oh, there we go. Yellow is the clear color, but not, like, by originality. Not by... Not the original clear color. You have to do the blue and light blue first. Okay, we got a lot here. One of these is going to have to clear vertically, I think. Worthy clearing. Just kind of figure out. I'm honestly lost looking at this one. I have no idea. There's like no good way to clear this. See if I can quit out and still start at the same level, because I don't want to do everything again before I come back to this. And I kind of need to go to sleep. What does sleep do? Select RL. Okay, yeah. I'm gonna stop for the night. My brain is a little fried right now from all that Puzzle League. But we will finish this the next time. So I'll just go ahead and stop that recording.